child say hallelujah. The Holy Ghost said his shadow served like a sensor that will see the danger, that will feel the danger that may be coming at you. Then the wind, the shadow informed the winds that danger is coming to her. Danger is coming to him. Danger is coming to his children. Then the wind take over to cover you up. Somebody shout, say, I'm covered. Say, neighbor, I'm covered. Say, neighbor, I'm covered. Say, neighbor, I'm covered. Not just by the wings, but I'm covered by the blood. Oh, come on. Say, neighbor, I'm covered by the blood. And then I witness you. And then I'm covered by the blood. I'm not just covered by, I'm not just covered by the wings. I bind under the shadow. Under the shadow of the Almighty. The shadow is a detective system that will detect the missiles of the enemies coming at you. That will detect the arrows of the enemies coming at you. Oh, I'm speaking now prophetically. I'm speaking now spiritually. You cannot catch the shadow with your hands. The shadow of God also represents his spirit. Oh, who the Lord talking to here? The shadow of God also represents his spirit. You can feel the presence of a shadow. Is that right? You may not grasp to it, but you can feel the presence of a shadow. Is that right there? Oh, glory to God. You can see the shadow. Sometimes God will open your eyes spiritually to see the shadow, his shadow in the spiritual realm. God will open your eyes to see the shadow of death or the shadow of evil around you. Somebody shout, say, praise the Lord. But God uses his shadow as a detector system that will detect the dangers before they reach you. That will detect the sorcerer before they reach you. That will detect the witchcraft before they reach you. Somebody shout, say, praise the Lord. As the Holy Ghost receive this message, and the message is sent to the wings. The wings of protection all around you. Then the wing, the refuge, the system of refuge take possession of the message. And they start to cover you up as a hen. As a hen cover its chicks. As the duck cover the ducklings, went over against the elements, against rain, against the enemy. Somebody shout, say, praise the Lord. Say, neighbor, say, neighbor, I'm covered. Oh, come on, put your hands together. I'm covered, I'm covered, I'm covered, I'm covered. Say, neighbor, I'm covered. I don't need to live in fear. I don't need to walk in fear. I don't need to go to bed in fear. Walk down the street in fear. I know I'm covered. Somebody shout, say, I'm covered. I'm covered not just by the wings, but by the blood of Jesus Christ. Because God, this is one of the reasons why are you so believing that you are covered? Why are you proclaiming and shouting that you are covered? From my past experience, number one, from my past experience, if God wanted for the enemies to have me long time ago, I could have been dead sleeping in my grave. Is that right? Because if the Lord was not on my side always, the enemies would have swallowed me up long time ago. Can I have a happy now? Is that right? Number one reason, my God has been there with me always. Is that right? As he promised to be with me. So I'm standing on my past experience with my God. Is that a witness here? Say, neighbor, I am standing upon my past past experience with my God. After all that I have been through, is that right? I'm still standing, proclaiming the name of my God. I'm still standing, pressing the name of my God. I'm still standing. God allowed me to stand. Some of them say glory to God. And secondly, so, in the name of Jesus, one of the things that gives me confidence to stand boldly and say, I lift up my eyes up to the hills, from whence cometh my help. Oh, glory to God. I'm not just basing this on my past experience, but I'm also basing this on the promises of God. Somebody say hallelujah. God told me if I can do it in his secret place. Somebody say secret place. Oh, let me go to another translation. Somebody shouts in secret place. If I can do it in this secret place of my God, then I make the refuge my habitation. Some of the shouts say habitation. Oh, I'm taking you somewhere. Some of the shouts say habitation. The 9 verses. God said, this is the reason that I made you and I allow you in my place of refuge. This is the reason why I am protecting you, why I am covering you. I will not allow any harm or hurt or danger to come to you. I will not allow hurt, harm, or danger to come to your dwelling. I gave my angel charge over thee. The 9 verse says, this is one of the reasons. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High God, you have made him your habitation place. Somebody shout, say hallelujah. Because you have made him your place of habitation, there shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any place come nigh thy dwelling. Is that what the word says? Is that what the Bible says? For he shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee in all your ways. In all your ways. But God said, in all your ways. He took you over all your ways. No matter where you may be, no matter where you may be traveling, no matter where you dwell right now, no matter where you decide to change your address to, when God says always, he means always, from the day you were born, hallelujah, throughout your teenage year, oh, who the Lord talks to you, throughout your teenage year, even into your adulthood, throughout, my goodness, your day of growth, even up to all age, God said, always, I will be with you always, even up to the end of time. Can no evil dwell, can no evil, this is your dwelling, can no evil, this is your children, can no evil. Hallelujah. He will preserve your going out and your coming in. He got to preserve your going out and your coming in. He is a God of covenant. Come on, shake hands with three people. Say, neighbor, our God is a God of covenant. He will keep his covenant unto his children. He will keep his covenant unto his people. He will keep his covenant. God is a covenant keeper. He was keep you sane in the name of Jesus. So now the Lord told me to encourage you this morning. Those who laid in the shelter of the Most High, yes, will find rest in that shadow. Is that right? This I declared about the Lord. He alone is our refuge, our place of safety. He is our God in whom we trust. For if you will, he will rescue us from every trap. Is that right? He will rescue us from every trap and protect us from deadly diseases. He will cover us with his feathers. He will shelter us with his wings. Is that right? His faithful promises are our armor. Armor and protection. Is that right? Say, neighbor, his faithful promises unto us are our armor. Armor and protection. Is that what the Bible says? Put on the whole armor of the Lord that you will be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Is that what the Bible says? Say, neighbor, I am standing on the promises of my God for my protection. Oh, glory to God. So I'm not afraid. My God told me, pray not yourself because of evil doers. Is that what the Bible says? Say, neighbor, the Bible says, pray not yourself because of evil doers. For evil doers shall soon be cut off. Is that what the Bible says? Say, neighbor, I'm standing on the promises of my God. When I go out, I'm going out pleading and walking in the promises of my God for my protection and the protection of my family, of my children. When I return home, oh glory to God, I don't go to bed in the spirit of fear. For God has not given me the spirit of fear,